Hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to Steezy Films. There's quite a number of apps on the Xbox One as it is, let alone the Microsoft Store using Universal Apps is another thing. Even there are some favourite apps I kinda use, and I wanna show you some apps as it is. So here are my top 5 Xbox One apps, let's get to it. Right, I need to search on the Microsoft Store to see if they have any disclaimer apps. Nope, there's no app for that. There's quite a number of apps as it is because of the whole, you know, Microsoft Store and using Universal Apps as another thing. There's a heap load of stuff. Then it is like certain like streaming apps that are somewhat legit and to watch certain shows somewhat for free. Since who of the right minds will port with this, which is really, really silly, I should say. There's YouTube for that. As well as other official streaming services, but I'd rather showcase some of the apps that I like using. Anyways, quick with Jibber Jabber, let's get on number 5, and that's Cortana. Now, sure, Cortana is somewhat not of an app, but it is stated in the apps on the Xbox One that it is an app, so loophole. But despite Cortana, I love using voice commands on my Xbox One as it is. Even though when the Xbox One first came out, I love using the Kinect as like a hands-free kind of thing for and using voice gestures for my Kinect, let alone doing other things with my Kinect is another thing. Despite getting an adapter for my Xbox One X as it is, and yes, I know you can use a blooming headset for using Cortana. Even I do have a wireless pair of headsets, but it's not as convenient as having a hands-free, you know, kind of thing. And hopefully, because I heard reports about Google Home as well as Amazon Echo might be implemented to the Xbox One, hopefully. But I love having a little chit-chat with Cortana, little Easter eggs and all that I know you can do on Cortana.
He just lost someone. Very close to him. I think we should give him some space.
Then it is as well as, you know, pausing, playing video, putting the volume up and down on the TV, just minor little things I just love. Then it is launching, you know, particular games on my Xbox One as it is. So that's number 5, and at number 4 is Ubisoft Club. Now, I've played a fair bit of Ubisoft games, and I do love using the Ubisoft Club kind of thing, and it's back on the Xbox 360 side of things when I used to play Ubisoft games on the Xbox 360 and get somewhat rewards. And it's nice that this thing, though, on this app on the Xbox One is a unique thing to get somewhat rewards and all that for certain games you play. Even games like Just Dance and also Rainbow Six Siege only tend to get these, like, challenges, weekly challenges, and it's nice to get some added extra stuff using the Ubisoft Club, just the Ubisoft Club alone, doing weekly challenges and get somewhat nice rewards when doing certain challenges, which is a nice bonus for those people that are really into like Rainbow Six Siege or Just Dance for Just Dance players, then it's IRL. All jokes aside, but you know what I mean, just loads of particular things and you can use with the Ubisoft Club if you have like a handful of games as it is, but mainly for those people that have you know, play like, you know, Rainbow Six Siege, you know, it's great for that and do all the weekly challenges and whatnot for that. So that's number 4, and then number 3 is YouTube. We'll use the YouTube audio library, but I'd rather do this so I don't get copyrighted. Do. I would say Netflix or any sort of streaming services, but anybody got time for a subscription. But YouTube though, since a free particular service that is whatever content YouTube has, is really, really good. Because I can only say, I must spend hours just constantly watching YouTube content on my Xbox more than playing video games on my Xbox, because it's kind of a bit of a guilty pleasure, honestly, to say. Then it is using YouTube as a really good solution for looking for like how-to tips and this and that for your gaming needs and searching for a particular playthrough, walkthrough, stuck on particular something. Just reasons why I think YouTube, not just for video content, but, you know, helping you alongside video games when it comes to helping you out and do a bit better on video games, I should say. But if you haven't done so already, do check out my YouTube channel, check out all the content I've been making. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge. Anywho. So that's number 3, and then number 2 is Microsoft Awards. Now, I've been using Xbox Live Awards for quite some years now, and just recently, this past year, they transferred me to Microsoft Awards, and I have to start using that now. Rest in peace, Xbox Live Awards. But however, the Microsoft Awards have somewhat keen interest on you to buy certain things to get points, and it's a bit of point grinding, nonetheless, for doing little certain tasks to get an extra few points, and it's a bit of a grind, is what I'm trying to say. If you like grindy RPGs, then this is the sort of thing for you, all jokes aside. Let alone just recently, they added a dedicated app on the Xbox One so you can start the grind, so you can actually build up points and end up just getting £5 of Xbox Live credit. But nonetheless, it's a neat app, and do try and take advantage, though, and I'm going to miss Xbox Live Awards as another thing. So that's number two, and at number one is... Country roads, take me home to the Yes, Air Server. Now, I'm sure there's quite a number of Windows Universal apps, but this takes the cake when it comes to utilization for the Xbox One as it is. Because of the somewhat Windows devices and services they use kind of discontinue somewhat way and now have like an iPhone and whatever. But when I discovered this app, and the utilizations I can use in this app is really, really good. Not just for music, though, but streaming videos, mirroring certain things, and I can actually mirror, get this right, my PC if I wanted to. It does own lack a little bit, but I don't want to utilize it too much because I had problems recording stuff on the PC using this method. But you get the idea, it's so universal, and you have to, don't have to use like just a particular device. You can use multiple devices, you know, Android, Windows, iOS, etc, etc. It's got, you know, them sort of castings that utilize quite well if you wanted to cast them on the TV and certain things, as well as capturing stuff on certain mobile devices, because I had captured, you know, certain stuff on my device before, and so sure it lags a little bit, and it's not the consistent you know, wired connection, because you know them wired adapters nonetheless for certain devices go for quite a bit, and this just is a one payment and utilized on other devices, not just iOS devices. Another thing which is mainly aimed for advertising, because you know it's meant to be for AirPlay users for iOS devices. But overall, even though I do have that particular adapter for my iOS device, but I can you know, use this app wirelessly, which is good, and I even paid this, get this right, I paid this app free with my mobile payment, is a whole different thing because I got it on sale with my mobile payment. But it's such a useful app for many different things for just the one payment. I do recommend you guys try and get it while it's on sale. So that's my top 5 Xbox One apps, hope you'll enjoy it. Now, there are quite a number of Xbox One apps as it is on the Xbox One, and I would go through quite a number of ones that most people use, but these are the ones I kind of use at the moment. I do utilize these quite often as YouTube. But other than that, though, you get what I mean. I do like using these apps and is utilizing some more apps on my Xbox One, and I thought I'll show you guys this and is my top 5 in general. Anyways, a bear go now. See you from Steety Films.